Is China a buy or a sell?
So China, by the way, China is incredibly interesting at this at this moment in time. So if you think about where they are, they had residential investment, depending on if you count just first order or first and second and third order, something around 10 to 29% of GDP. But they have a shrinking population. So that is definitively unsustainable growth. So if you think about what Xi is trying to do, he's trying to rebalance his economy. And by the way, in a way that I don't think you or I would argue is not smart, but the way he's going—
In fact, he's trying to do some of the same things that people here would like to do, but just find incredibly difficult because they're so, you know, politically divisive.
By the way, 100%, I have no doubt that there's politicians around the world that are jealous about the degrees of freedom that Xi has. But I think that what's caught kind of Western investors by surprise is kind of the step function fashion he's doing it in, and the economic damage he's willing to tolerate to get from here to there. And, you know, as an investor, I think one of the things is, you know, based on what's happened the past couple of months, it's pretty clear, you know, every Chinese company is viewed to be a state-owned enterprise to one degree or another. The other thing I think from an investment perspective that's really interesting and that's gotten a lot of attention from Chairman Gensler and others is the VIE or shell company structure of Chinese companies that are listed here. And, you know, I think that those companies will largely have to delist. And by the way, for a lot of them, there's a mechanism for them to just port to Hong Kong. But, you know, for 20 years, Chinese tech companies having Western capital and a Western vested interest in their success very much suited China's goals. They don't need that anymore. So they can take their $700 billion and take it back onshore into Hong Kong. And I think that's what they're going to do. So when it comes to the U.S. Chinese listings, if I were investors, I'd be really careful here.
What about earlier stage investments, Chinese venture capital, for example?
So again, I think it's going to be a while before those have an avenue to go public. There's some really big names that might go public near term in Hong Kong to make a point. But I think overall, that path from private to public in China is just going to take longer. And valuations, I think, are, you know, permanently at lower multiples because of, you know, because of effectively the state tax and state utility.
That sounds to me, Don, like potentially a big problem for firms like Sequoia, for example, or Tiger Global that have done so well investing in early stage Chinese enterprises and then, you know, riding their evolution to the public markets.
So nobody's going to cry for Sequoia or Tiger Global. And I think they have plenty of dollars outside of China that are doing extraordinarily well right now. But, you know, my guess is there's a lot of debates going on in their boardrooms about how aggressively to invest going forward. The other thing I would say about the asset management industry overall is that they're a little bit economically compromised. China has invested a lot of money in Western asset managers, so it's hard for them to take too hard a stance when it comes to forward investments.
Are you allocating toward China or away from China?
I would say we are not putting money into China right now.